hotel. Mum ran a hotel, country pub. My parents ran it, but Mum ran it. But Dad was very charismatic, and of course we moved to Victoria and took up the lease of a local hotel called the Criterion Hotel.
Where is it?
In Rushworth, which is Gold Rush country. It's about an hour from Bendigo. It's a very cold place, but I have so many wonderful memories of this this little town, little Gold Rush town, beautiful old heritage buildings. We our pub was the top pub, and Mum never liked calling it a pub, so we had to call it the hotel. So we never used the word pub. They ran a really slick operation. They were good business people. Dad was front of house. Mum, just everything. She had to get everything. We did meals. We had accommodation, the typical, you know, hotel room accommodation. They had events. My father was involved with the local, I think the high school had a Gilbert's, had a dramatic society, and they did Gilbert and Sullivan. So back in the 60s it was really quite popular, I think. So they had the Mikado and Pirates of Penzance. And I remember seeing a envelope come through to the hotel, a letter, and on it, and because the lead role was Frederick in Pirates of Penzance. And he was known as Ray Frederick Willis. That was that popular. He's a very good singer, Dad. Very good singer. Yeah, so there was lots of activity, lots of vibrancy, lots of people coming through the hotel, but lots of hard work too. Mm-hmm. So us kids, we went to the local... I started school in Rushworth, and I remember being in a specialist maths class when I was in reception or year one or something. I think because I was good at maths, and I think they must have had a program of developing kids. It was a local Catholic school.
Was it a big school?
No, I remember the school. It felt big. Mm-hmm. It felt like there were a lot of kids, and there may well have been. Mm. I can't remember how many children went there. I remember I always felt like I learnt a lot there. Mm. May I say, compared to here. When I came here, it was, and I think there's elements of I didn't want to leave Rushworth. I was only in, I think, grade two, grade three when we left, and I loved it. And we used to have the run of the town, the things we used to do.
Was it the only school, or was there a state school?
Was a state school, and that was quite big as well. There was a high school. I don't know if there was a local high school, but it might have been a regional high school, because there's not a lot of people. There's only a few hundred people in Rushworth, but a very tight-knit community. We learnt to swim there. There was a local swimming pool, and Mum had never learnt to swim, and she remembered, she said, "No, you will all learn to swim," because I always wanted to learn to swim, and we didn't have a pool. We weren't allowed to swim in the River Light near Henry Bridge, and her mother would never let her because it was dangerous.
Yeah.
And so she felt very strongly that we had to learn to swim, and so we did. So I learned to swim. I still remember swimming in that pool. Beautiful people, kids that I still am friends with now.
I was going to ask about some of the memories.
Yeah, there's
fellow students and teachers.
I don't remember my teachers and their names. I remember the people and the kids, because we was a bit of a gang of us that used to run around. We were so little, but we used to have the run of the town. Literally, we were always off exploring. There was an old burnt out house across the road from the hotel, and in Victoria and in country towns, in Rushworth, its name reflects what you think might have. The gold rush was huge, and there was an old gold mine called Rue. That is now quite a tourist attraction, but at the time it was a derelict, so we weren't allowed to go there because, you know, mine shafts. The whole place was littered with mine shafts. And the middle of the town had an old tram track, but it was playgrounds were in the middle of the main street. So you had one-way streets up one way
You'd
go up the other way, and the old traditional main street shops on either side, huge main street, but reflected that gold rush activity. Massive railway network there, of course, because, again, the gold mine and moving the gold out. This town was in the middle of bush, so we were surrounded by bush. It was gorgeous. We were involved. My dad was captain coach of the local football side, so, you know, we used to watch football. I was too young to play netball, but I remember swimming.
Yeah.
I remember the hospital. I remember going to... we had our own hospital, country hospital at Rushworth. And Mum, I remember going to visit Mum. We weren't allowed to go in because we were kids. I'll never forget that. We weren't allowed to go in to see our own mother.
Yeah.
And because she had a miscarriage and we didn't know what she'd had done. But I remember looking through the window, seeing her, not being able to visit her. We had wonderful people that worked in the hotel who were great friends of my mother and helped. And I've got this great memory of this cook, Mrs. Muir was her name. And she was the cook, and she wasn't a very good cook. And as a child, I'll never forget it. There we were, because there was the dining room, there was the ladies' lounge, the dining room, formal dining room, and then there was the kitchen, and then there was the back room where us kids used to eat. And there was an old back stairs that we'd go up and stay or live, you know, and with certain rooms we were allowed to. There was sort of that back private section, and then there was the public where people stayed. So we weren't at any cost allowed to go into that formal area. Of course, we always did when we were, you know, and we weren't allowed. And I remember one, and there was a beautiful old staircase that's still there. We used to slide down the banisters. Of course, one time I fell off. And one time one of my friends, Jimmy Morgan, fell off and he had a big lump on his head. And it was massive, this lump. I still can see this lump that Jimmy Morgan had. We had lots of fun, but this cook, Mrs. Muir, she dished up this lamb's tongue, would you believe?
Oh, yeah.
It was hideous. It was just hideous. I still remember her dishing up, you eat this. I'm like, I'm not eating that. I still remember, and I went, oh, God. So, yes, not the best. The stuff that we got, it was awful, you know. It was awful. It was, but you got to laugh. You've absolutely got to laugh. I contracted scarlet fever.
Really?
Yeah, really bad, which is a really bad throat infection, strep, a throat infection. And so my parents, and then you'd think, oh, God, this is terrible. And in Maroopna Base Hospital was a large hospital. There's a basin or a reservoir called Maroopna Basin. I assume it's still there, which was the water source for the town and region. And we were, of course, highly contagious.
Ooh.
And I could barely swallow. It was really terrible. We got put in quarantine, and it's awful. We got shipped into this hospital and we were in isolation. So the decision was, I remember my mum says, well, Karen, you know, we're running a business. Right. And I said, so you shipped us off to the hospital? Yep. And kept the pub going, kept the hotel going. So we all got put in hospital.
That's you and your siblings?
Yes,
yeah.
All of us.
Mm.
And I remember I had to have this, what was it called, the big procaine penicillin injections, so these massive white, huge injections. And we used to have them. It was awful. We were in isolated glass cubes.
Good heavens.
Yeah, we were completely, completely isolated from everyone.
And from each other.
From each other. So if you think of a row of beds and there's a glass
partition
with doors, you couldn't get out. You couldn't. Yeah. And again, I remember this nurse came in. It was my first experience of nursing, which wasn't very good,
really?
And they weren't very nice. And one nurse, and I said, oh. What do you want for dinner? I said, oh, what's this Bonox? Oh, if you order it, you have to drink it. Okay. I didn't have any idea. So I got dished up this Bonox, which was hideous, salty and horrible.
Yeah.
And I didn't drink it. But they said, you won't. So I didn't get anything else. Yeah. Oh, it was awful. Yeah. So that...
Did you all have scarlet fever, or was it just you? Well, I know
I had it really bad. I think all of us had to be put... in, and I'm not sure if my older sister had it slightly less than me.
I see.
I think, I remember just, it was.
So how long were you there?
I think we were there for a few weeks.
Good.
Yeah,
great.
It wasn't just overnight. It was a number of, so we, that was quite difficult. I remember hating it, and, you know, you'd sit there and you'd be...
And you're only little.
Yeah, we were little kids. And I remember they had a party... kids party. I could see the kids party across the corridor and down through the door, and they had this kids party. And going, I can't go to this kids party. You know, it was really, wasn't very nice at all. Yeah, it wasn't good at all. But I must admit, I still found something to laugh at with the Bonox. So maybe that's where my defiance and resilience came from.
Who knows?
I don't know.
How long after that did you leave?
We came to Gawler in 68, the end of 68, 69. So we were there, we were in Rushworth, the lease was 3 years. I do know that I think Dad wanted to stay on and Mum said no.
Mm.
No, because it was killing her.
Yeah.
It was exhausting. Loved the people. But it was just so,
yeah.
And four kids.
Oh, absolutely.
Young, you know. So we came and settled in Gawler. I remember when we came back and we actually said...